सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्भरं अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमस्त्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। Siddhanti, in the Tippana we saw the answers. Siddhanti answered the objection regarding Ekatva of Jiva and Brahma by giving various examples countering all sorts of Pramanas quoted by the Purva Pakshi. So continuing, Sakshi Brahmaikya Vishaya Akshepaha. So Jiva, who is this Jiva? Samsari Jiva. Sakshi is said to be different now. Purva Pakshi says that, okay, Sakshi may be one with Brahma. Sakshi, who is not involved in samsara really. So whoever that Sakshi is, as per the Purva Pakshi, whether that Sakshi can be one. So there is an akshepa, whether Sakshi can be one with Brahma. Now, Jiva Atirikta Sakshi Nasti. Can there be Sakshi different than the Jiva? Are there two entities? Jiva is one and then Dvasuparna says the mantra. So, taking Dvasuparna as Dvasuparnau, actually, in Chandasa Prayoga, Dvasuparna means two. There are two birds, says Mundaka Upanishad. One is Jiva, the other is Ishvara. One, this Jiva, sadhu pipalam atti, he partakes of the karma phala, whereas the other is Sakshi, watches over. So are there really two? So Jiva atirikta Sakshi nasti, sattve api. Even if you think that there is some Sakshi separate from Jiva, sattve api Sakshi nana iti shanka. Sakshi is nana. There cannot be, just like earlier we said, many jivas, right? Sakshi, first of all, Sakshi is not different from Jiva. If at all Sakshi is different from Jiva, then Sakshi also nana. There are many Sakshis. Yaduktam sukadukhadeha antakkarana dharmaha tachya antakkarana manekam. You said, Purva Pakshi is telling the Siddhanti that there are many antakkaranas. Jivas are not many, antakkaranas are many. Tasmad ekopadistha sukadukhadeha dharmaha upadyantara sambandinaha na bhavanti. Upadyantara sambandinaha na bhavanti dharmaha. These dharmas which are one upadhi nishtha. Sukadukhas are dharmas which are there in one upadhi. They do not connect with another upadhi. One who is connected to another upadhi. Upadhyantara sambandina. One who has sambandha with another upadhi. That entity or those many others who have various upadhis, they do not have any experience of sukha-dukha of other upadhis. Or if you take one upadhi compared to the experience of this sambandhi, who has sambandha with this particular upadhi where there are sukha dukkha daya, The others who are connected with other upadis, they don't have sukha dukkhas. We have seen this. So this will be easy to see the section. Now Sakshi also same issue. There Sakshi to sarva sukha dukkhadi Sakshya dharma dharma asambaddha eka eva. So Siddhanti has said Sakshi is not mixed up with the upadi. One who is mixed up with the upadi, he has sukha dukkha experience. Where the Sakshi is disconnected. Sakshi has no sukha dukkha. He watches over sukha dukkha. Like a bystander. Bystander, he looks at sukha dukkha in the antakkarana. Pratibimba Chaitanya is there, but he is separate, really not connected to any upadhi. Sakshi tu sarva sukha dukkhadi sakshya dharma. Sakshi and Sakshya Bheda is there. Dharmas are Sakshya and Sakshi is Asambaddha. Eka eva. There is only one Sakshi. Tasya cha brahmana aikyam vaktum shakyate eva iti. So Siddhanti says that Sakshi who is one, he can have oneness with Brahma. Tanna. That is not right, says the Purva Pakshi. Kartrutva bhoktrutva adi dharma vishishta jiva atirikta sakshi sattve pramana bhavat. Already said in bold here. This is a sankshepa. The topic. There is no pramana for existence of sakshi who is separate from jiva. And who is this jiva? Jiva is dharma vishishta. If jiva is sukha dukkha adi dharma vishishta, kartrutva bhoktrutva adi dharma vishishta, adi padena sukha dukkha also. Kartrutva bhoktrutva at the bhoktrutva at the anandamaya kosha, kartrutva at the vijnanamaya kosha, those dharmas are qualifying this jiva, vishishta jiva. This individual is having this kosha. So he has kartrutva, bhoktrutva, then sukha dukkha adaya, these are manomaya kosha dharmas. They separate out this individual. Thereby this individual is having these dharmas and Sakshi is not separate because pramana bhava. There is no pramana for Sakshi being separate from jiva. So same issues that we dealt with jiva, we'll have the same objection with Sakshi also. Sakshi angikare api. Sakshi angikare. That is Sakshi angikare api. So Sakshi angikare pakshe api. Sa ekaha iti abhyupagantum na shakyate. Even if you say Sakshi is separate from jiva, how will you establish he is one? Kintu aneke sakshinaha iti eva yuktam. There are many Sakshis. As many jivas are there, those many sakshis are there. Tatha hi antakkaranam taddharma sukadukkhadayascha na antakkaranena nava indriyena vishayi kriyante. Antakkarana and antakkarana dharma. Antakkarana nishta dharma. Antakkarana has dharmas which are sukadukkhas. They are in antakkarana. Antakkaranena va indriyena na vishayi kriyante. The antakkarana dharmas as well as the antakkarana. The antakkarana is the substratum, base on which these dharmas rest, sukha dukkha. So neither the antakkarana nor the sukha dukkhas, which are antakkarana dharmas, are objectified by antakkarana itself or indriyas. Indriyas are outward to the antakkarana. They cannot objectify the antakkarana. They cannot objectify the antakkarana dharmas also. Similarly, antakkarana itself cannot cognize its own dharmas, nor can it cognize itself. It cannot objectify itself. Kintu sakshina eva iti vedanta siddhantaha. So what is the siddhanta? Sakshi objectifies the antakkarana and antakkarana dharma. So sakshinascha ekatve yada ekantakkarana ekantakkaranasta sukadukkhadaya sakshina vishayi kriyante तदा सर्व अंतकरणगत सुख दुखादय अपि विषय क्रियेरन. इफ साक्षी इज वन देन दी अंतकरणस्थ सुख दुख धर्मस विच आर ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड बाय द साक्षी इन वन अंतकरण देन सिमिलरली द सेम साक्षी बीइंग वन ही वुड ऑब्जेक्टिफाइ द अंतकरण गत सुख दुख ऑफ ऑल सर्व जस्ट लाइक ही इज ऑब्जेक्टिफाइंग वन ही वुड ऑब्जेक्टिफाइ अंतकरण गत सुख दुखादय ऑफ एवरी अंतकरण मीनिंग इन एवरी शरीर देर इज अंतकरण एंड ऑल दोज विल बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड बाय द साक्षी सिंगल साक्षी. That is a possibility, विषय क्रियेरन विदिलिंग तथा अनुभवाभावाद एव अनेके साक्षिण इति अभ्युपगंतव्यम्. Thereby, there is no such anubhava. I am a sakshi. Let's say I am a sakshi. I am not a jiva. I am a sakshi. If I am a sakshi, jiva is a samsari. Sakshi is not a samsari. So if I am a sakshi, jiva who is connected with the antakkarana. Now you say antakkarana itself cannot objectify itself or its dharmas. Thereby, sakshi objectifies it. Sakshi knows that there is sukhavritti, dukkhavritti ityadi. He objectifies the antakkarana and antakkarana gata dharmas, sukha dukkhas. But do I have experience of others antakkarana? I do not. I don't have the experience of others antakkarana and nor do I have the experience of sukha dukkha of others. I can infer, looking at someone, I can infer that this person is sukhi dukhi. Possibly, you know, looking at the mood, looking at the facial expressions, looking at how the person conducts oneself, I may infer, but I do not have anubhava of others antakkarana gata sukha dukkha. Thereby, anubhavanam abhavat. अनेके साक्षिण इति अभ्युपगंत. यू हैव टू एक्सेप्ट मेनी साक्षीज एज मेनी अंतकरण आर देयर दोज मेनी साक्षीज हैव टू एक्सेप्टेड न च अस्ति अस्मिन् पक्षे कोपि दोषः. सो हियर एट दिस पॉइंट वी आर नॉट टेकिंग अप दिस साक्षी बिजनेस बिकॉज साक्षी हैज नॉट बीन डिस्कस्ड. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट. सो सिद्धांति न च अस्ति अस्मिन् पक्षे कोपि दोषः. वी लेट इट बी. ओके देर आर मेनी साक्षीज. लेट इट बी राइट नाउ. यस्य हि साक्षिणः यदन्तःकरण उपाधिः तदन्तःकरणगता एव धर्माः तेन साक्षिणा विषयी क्रियेरन् न अन्य उपाधिगता. सो फॉर द पूर्वपक्ष हु इज अ वेदांती. नाउ लेट्स से ही इज अ वेदांती. द सिद्धांती इज नॉट एंसरिंग टू दिस क्वेश्चन राइट नाउ बिकॉज इट्स एन आक्षेप. ओके लेट्स से दैट देर आर मेनी साक्षीज. लेट्स मूव ऑन बिकॉज वी हैव अदर थिंग्स टू डील विद बिफोर वी लैंड ऑन साक्षी. सो देर आर मेनी साक्षीज हु हैव who witness many antakarana because they are upadis. Evam cha sakshinah anekatvat na tesham ekena brahmana aikam yujyeta. So now the akshepa ends by saying that since sakshis are many and since you cannot point out any dosha in my analysis, says the Purupakshi, there is nothing wrong by saying that sakshis are many. Otherwise, sakshi would have an anubhava of a person would have anubhava. You would have anubhava of other antakarana dharmas also. Since you do not have and you have accepted that the sakshi has, it is sakshi pratyaksha. Sukha dukha are pratyaksha, but to whom? Sakshi pratyaksha. So we make a category, sakshi pratyaksha. So if you agree sakshi pratyaksha, so your antakarana dharmas are sakshi pratyaksha, you are the sakshi. Do you have, is it sakshi pratyaksha? The other antakkarana dharmas, are they sakshi pratyaksha? They are not. So if they are not, then sakshi has to be many. Sakshis have to be many. And thereby, there is no dosha in this paksha that I have explained. Thereby, now what we can conclude is, evam cha sakshina anekatva. Then sakshis are many. Na tesham ekena brahmana aikyam yujyeta. This is my problem, says the Siddhanti. If sakshis are many, how can you make all sakshis as one Brahma? This is the crux of the objection. Further, in the 57th, रिपल ही सेज अंतकरणस्य इंद्रिय विषयत्वम अंतकरण कैन इट बी इंद्रिय विषय बिकॉज इट हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड कैन अंतकरण बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड बाय इंद्रियास वी हैव गॉट अवे बाय सेइंग दैट अंतकरण कैन नॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड बाय इंद्रियास हाउ सो दिस इज एनालाइज्ड इंद्रियाणि पंचीकृत इज अ टिप्पण लेटर ओके इंद्रियाणि पंचीकृत भूततत्कार्याण्येव विषयीकुर्युः what do the indriyas objectify they objectify the panchikrita bhutas not apanchikrita bhutas and their karyas so sukshma non grossified elements they cannot objectify the indriyas sense organs cannot objectify they can objectify only the grossified elements and their karya सो आकाशः वायु अग्निः आपः एंड पृथ्वी दे आर सटल एंड देन देयर इज पंचीकरण दे मिक्स अप विद ईच अदर हाफ ऑफ ईच इट्स ओन एंड वन फोर्थ ऑफ द अदर्स ऑल दिस इज डिस्कस्ड इन द अदर ग्रंथास इंट्रोडक्टरी वेदांत ग्रंथास तत्वबोध एटसेट्रा सो दे टॉक अबाउट हाउ दिस पंचीकरण इज डन एंड दे ऑल्सो टॉक अबाउट ईच विषया यस ईच गुणा of each and every mahabhutas so akashasya shabdah akashaya shabda guna so shabda sparsha roopa rasa gandha respectively are individual gunas of each and every mahabhuta when they mix up and become grossified all have each and every guna primarily their own guna but in the subtle non-grossified apanchikrita bhutas they have created sense organs the sense organs have come from them and each mahabhuta which is also called as a devata in chandogya upanishad shashta adhyaya so there the devata in the form sat devata which is the brahma from brahma akasha ityadi is born there trivitkaranam is used but the other akasha and vayu are included when the teja onwards srishti is talked about agni onwards in chandogya upanishad but we know that the other two are created before the agni or teja is created now these sense organs are created so that the devatas are objectified the panchamahabhutas devatas called as devatas there because sad devata is continuing there is manifesting they wanted to be objectified just like devata thought that let me aikshata bahusyam prajayeti let me be many similarly devatas just becoming many is useless if they cannot interact with each other vyavahara has to be possible so vyavahara can be possible only when sense organs are created mana is created buddhi is created etc because it is all for jivasya bhoga based on the karma which is due thereby srishti is there srishti prakriya is talked about in different ways in different upanishads now these indriyas which have been created by the sukshma coming together and the sukshma shabda they cannot objectify they have been put together by the since the devatas wanted to be objectified shabda objectified means their own gunas shabda sparsha roopa rasa gandha they have undergone panchikaranam or trivitkaranam and then the sense organs are formed mana is formed antakarana and then buddhi ityadi all of these are formed so what can objectify what there is a niyama so here it is said indriyani panchikrita bhuta tat karyanye vishayi kuryuh they can objectify only the grossified sense organs can objectify only the grossified mahabhutas and their karyas not the sukshma and their karyas atra api asti vakshyamana ritya bhedah therefore there is bheda which will come up which has to be talked about chakshurindriyam neela pita adi varna yukta ghata adi nishtha nailya adi rupam tadadhar bhuta ghata adi cha vishayi karoti so chakshuradi indriya eyes etc all the five sense organs, which are Jnanendriyas. What do they objectify? Neela Peetadi Varna. Yukta Ghatadi. So Ghata Ghata Patadi Ityadi. They have Rupa Rasa Ityadi are there. So which in Chakshu is talked about Neela Peeta. Black or dark color, Peeta, yellow, etc. So all these gunas are there in the Ghata. Ghata is endowed with these now, these colors. So Neela Peetadi Varna Yukta Ghata, etc. Nishtha Ghata Ityadi, these are the Vishayas. Vishayas will have what? Nailya, etc. So Naila, Neela, Paitya Ityadi. So Nailyadi Rupam, which is there in the Ghata. Chakshurindriya will objectify only that Nailya Ityadi in the Ghata. And further what? Tad Adhara Bhuta Ghatadi cha. So it will, the eyes can objectify Ghata and Ghatanishta Rupa. Because that is the only scope of the Indriya, Chakshurindriya. Similarly, extends to others. He takes up the others also. Twagindriyam cha. Twagindriyam api sparsham tadashrayam cha ubhayam vishayi karoti. So in the case of Indriyas also, the eyes and the Twagindriya, sense of touch, the organ, sense organ of touch, they objectify the particular quality they can objectify, and Ashraya also, where these qualities are there. Cha ubhayam vishayi karoti. There is a differentiation in the sense organs also. Whereas the other three, Jivha, Grana, Shravanani, Tu, Trini Indriyani, the other three Indriyas, the taste, olfactory organ, and the sense organ of hearing. These three, Vastvashrita, Rasagandha, Shabdan, Eva, Kramad, Vishayi Kurvanti. They can objectify only the properties. Natu, Tadashre, Dravyam. They cannot objectify the dravya itself. You hear the sound, you smell something, and you can only taste something. But that something, what that dravya, you don't taste. What you taste is the taste in the dravya, only the property in the substance. But you do not actually taste the object itself, only the rasa. So you cannot, the tongue cannot objectify the vastu itself, but vastu ashrita guna it can. So guni it cannot objectify, only guna it can objectify. So that is the difference between the five. Two can objectify the guna as well as the guni, the dravya, whereas the ashraya also, and here the other three can objectify only the guna, not the ashraya. And there is a tippana, tatahi rasadyashraya dravyam chakshushaha va twachaha va vishayi bhavati natu jivha dehe. So how is the ashraya objectified? The ashraya, if you are eating food, the tongue knows the taste, but food itself is objectified by, you can see it or you can feel the food with touch. So when you are eating also, the tongue also has a sense of touch, because there is skin. So the Twagendriya pervades the tongue also. The tongue can feel the dravya, meaning the ashraya of the rasaguna, whereas the tongue, the sense of taste within the tongue objectifies rasa. Natu jivha dehe tathahi madhuryadyasvadane jivhaya madhuryadi guna eva grihyate. So if you are eating something sweet, then the taste or the organ of taste within the tongue tastes the sweet. However, it cannot, na tadashre dravyam, it cannot objectify the food that you are eating, the sweet that you are eating, that it cannot, you call it sweet because it tastes sweet. But if it is a laddu, then the shape of the laddu, the ashraya laddu itself cannot be objectified by the jivha, jivendriya. Tachya twagendriyena eva gruhyate. So the sense of touch in the tongue can make out the shape, etc. The object itself, the food, the way it is, it can be objectified only by the sense of touch, not by the rasendriya within jivha. So this is the differentiation made here, so that what is being shown here is yogyata is needed for indriya to objectify something. Yogyata is needed. Can indriyas objectify the sukha dukkha adi which is there in the antakarana? And this will be expanded to everything then. What can objectify what can be known only by the yogyata which is there. Ata eva etat trenapi. Etat trenapi indriyena antakaranam na vishayi kriyate. Therefore, these three cannot objectify the antakarana. Tatha evana chakshusha tvacha cha antakaranam vishayi kriyate. What about the other two? Can they objectify the antakarana? No. Similar reasoning. Yogyata is not there. Yataha baihya panchikrita bhutani tatkaryam rupashrem sparshashrem va vastu chakshusha tvacha cha vishayi kriyante. Because only baihya panchikrita bhutani, which are external to the indriyas, they alone can be objectified by the, those alone can be objectified by the chakshurindriya as well as twacha also. Antakkaranam tu apanchikrita bhuta karyatvat. Antakkarana is a product of the apanchikrita bhutas, mahabhutas. Therefore, netra tvachoho na vishayi bhavati. It cannot be objectified by netra. It is not an object for the eyes and the sense of touch. Ata eva apanchikrita bhuta karyam netrendriyam api netrendriyena na vishayi kriyate. And therefore, apanchikrita bhuta karya, netra, netrendriyam api, the eyes cannot objectify itself for the same reason. Eyes cannot see themselves. Paihya vastuni eva sarvendriyanam vishayi bhavanti. Only whatever is outward to the sense organ is objectified by that particular sense organ, and it can objectify only that particular guna, not other guna. Similarly, it cannot objectify the twagendriya, and chakshurindriya cannot objectify anything more than the their own gunas and their the guna ashraya also. Indriya apeksha antaratvad antakranam na indriyanam vishayi bhavati. And this is another way it has shown that the indriya, compared to the indriya, antakrana is interior. Therefore, antakrana cannot be an object to indriya. Antakrana se swavritti avishayatvam. What about the vrittis now? Antakrana vrittis. Can antakrana vrittis objectify antakkarana? See, what is this analysis for? The Siddhanti wants to land on the Sakshi. Who is the Sakshi? And who can objectify it? How can we understand the Sakshi? So he has started from whatever is the available set of tools. Available set of tools, we have Indriyas, we have Antakkarana, we have Buddhi. Antakkarana, in Antakkarana we have Mana and Buddhi. So Antakkarana, and externally we have sense organs, organs of knowledge, Jnanendriya, perception. How about the Antakkarana vrittis? You say that there is a vritti formed, Brahmakara vritti, this vritti, that vritti, you keep on talking about Ghatakara vritti, Patakara vritti, Mathakara vritti. What about these vrittis? Can there be Antakkaranakara vritti? Antakkaranasya swavritti avishayatvam. That is not possible, is explained here. Kincha antakkaranam na swavrittehe api gochari bhavati. Antakkarana cannot know itself, meaning the its own vrittis. Swavrittis antakkarana vritti. Antakkarana vrittis cannot know the antakkarana. Antakkaranasya vrittyashrayatvat na tat swashrita vrittehe vishayi bhavitum arhati. Since vrittis themselves are based in antakkarana, they cannot objectify their ashraya. यथा अग्न्याश्रिता दाह शक्ति ही स्वाश्रय अतिरिक्ते अतिरिक्त इंधनाद्येव विषयी करोति तथा अंतकरण वृत्तिरपि स्वाश्रय अंतकरण व्यतिरिक्तमेव वस्तु विषयी कुर्यात्। एन एग्जांपल इज गिवन अग्न्याश्रिता दाह शक्ति। अग्नि हैज अ सर्टन शक्ति टू बर्न, सो अग्नि कैन बर्न बिकॉज इट हैज दाह शक्ति। दिस दाह शक्ति कैन इट बर्न अग्नि इटसेल्फ? इट कैनॉट, बिकॉज अग्नि इज आश्रय फॉर दैट दाह शक्ति। इट कैनॉट बर्न इट्स ओन आश्रय। इट कैन बर्न इंधन विच इज स्व आश्रय व्यतिरिक्त अतिरिक्त डिफरेंट, दैट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अग्नि, सेपरेट फ्रॉम इट्स ओन आश्रय इट कैन बर्न। तथा सिमिलरली अंतकरण वृत्तिरपि स्वाश्रय, स्वाश्रय इज अंतकरणाश्रय, सॉरी वृत्ति आश्रय, अंतकरण वृत्ति इज ऑल्सो कैनॉट ऑब्जेक्टिफाई देर ओन आश्रय। स्वाश्रय अंतकरण व्यतिरिक्तम एव वस्तु विषय कुर्यात्। ओनली समथिंग विच इज अदर देन इट्स ओन आश्रय वृत्ति आश्रय वृत्तिस कैन ऑब्जेक्टिफाई, तस्माद् अंतकरणम् नैव स्ववृत्तेः विषयी भवति। Thereby, अंतकरण is not an object to its own वृत्तिस। There is a tippana on this. An objection is raised here. Nanu, what kind of example have you given? अंधकारावृतम् अंधकारावृतम् गृहं यथा अंधकारस्य आश्रयः विषयश्च भवति यथा वा चैतन्यम् एकमेव स्वाज्ञानस्य आश्रय विशेष्य भवति एवमेव अंतकरणमपि स्ववृत्तेः आश्रयः विशेष्य कुतो न स्यात् इति चेत् न। सो दिस ऑब्जेक्शन इज रिफ्यूटेड। अ पॉसिबिलिटी इज गिवन बाय द पूर्वपक्षी। लुक एट दिस अंधकारावृतम् गृहम्। देयर इज अ हाउस। अंधकार इज अ अंधकार इज अ द्रव्य इज अ अंधकार इज अ भाव पदार्थ। सो अंधकार डार्कनेस तमस तमस चलती। सो देर आर मंत्रास और देर आर यू नो तमस चलती, देर इज अ प्रयोग लाइक दैट। सो तमह इज मूविंग, देर इज पिच डार्कनेस एंड वी हैव सीन लास्ट टाइम दैट तमह इज भाव पदार्थ। नाउ If Andhakara, Tamas, has covered up a Gruha, a house, there is darkness over the house, and we say that it is very dark. So, Gruham, Yatha Andhakarasre Ashrayaha Visheshcha Bhavati. So, that Gruha, which has darkness now, that house which has darkness is its Ashraya, and it is also its Vishaya. So, darkness is resting in the Gruha and it is also objectifying the Gruha. Objectifying in a sense, it is covering the Gruha with darkness. It is not covering something else. The darkness which is there in the house is making the house itself dark. So your Agni example is all right, but look at this example. Is it possible, if you agree with even a single example, that it is possible for something to be Ashrita as well as making the ashraya as a vishaya? So this is one example. Another example given by Purvapakshi is what the Siddhanti says. Siddhanta is that chaitanyam ekameva swa ajnanasya ashraya visheshcha bhavati. Where is the ajnana? Ajnana is in chaitanya. If ajnana is in chaitanya, so chaitanya has ajnana, and ajnana is ajnanasya ashraya, thereby chaitanya is ashraya of ajnana and vishayascha bhavati. Chaitanya swajnanasya ashraya vishayascha bhavati. Avarana shakti of ajnana, what is it veiling? It is veiling the chaitanya. So it remains in chaitanya and veils the chaitanya. So it is making it an object. It's a vishaya for ajnana. So here's given the siddhanta example itself, take either laukika example or your siddhanta itself, there it is possible. So how do you deny the possibility of antakarana vritti, knowing antakarana? Why not? Maybe in this manner it is possible. एवं अंतःकरणमपि स्ववृत्ते आश्रय विशेषच कुतो न स्यात् इति चेत् न सिद्धांति सेज दैट्स नॉट ट्रू योर एग्जांपल एंड माय एग्जांपल देयर इज अ डिफरेंस इन माय अग्नि एग्जांपल अग्नि एंड दाह शक्ति ऑफ अग्नि आर इनसेपरेबल दे आर इनसेपरेबल दे आर also at the same level of reality, but we'll say they are inseparable. Grahandakaravat yatra ashrayashrenau bhinnau bhavataha tatra ekaseva ashrayatvam vishayatvam cha syat. You are right in your example, it is right, but comparison is not right. Because in this example, andakara is आश्रय आश्रयेणौ भिन्नौ वन हु हैज एन आश्रय अंधकार हैज एन आश्रय अस्य अस्ति इति आश्रयी अंधकार इज आश्रयी वेर एज द गृह इज आश्रय सो वेर द व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन आर दे वन गृह एंड अंधकार आर नॉट वन दे आर सेपरेट अंधकार इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम द गृह So where they are different, ashraya and ashrayi are different, tatra ekasyeva ashrayatvam vishayatvam cha syat. There it is possible that ashrayatvam is also possible for griha and vishayatvam is also possible for griha because andhakara is separate from griha. Yatra tu vanni tadashritat daha shakti vad ashraya ashrayanu na bhinnau bhavataha. The ashray and ashrayi in the case of vanni and daha shakti. You cannot show daha shakti as separate from vanni. Wherever there is daha shakti, there is definitely vanni. So there is a vyapti. Yatra yatra daha shakti, tatra tatra vanni bhavati eva. Nishchayena bhavati. Yatra vanni nasti, tatra daha shakti api nasti. So we have vyapti whereby we know that ashray ashrayi, you know, in this case, although they are ashray and ashrayi, Never do you see them separately. You can see Andhakara elsewhere also. Forget Graha, you can see Andhakara elsewhere also. Need not be only in Graha. So Andhakara and Graha are different. In this case, however, Ashraya Ashrayi Sambandha is there, but they are not different. Vanni and Tadgata, Daha Shakti are same. They are not Bhinna. So na bhinnau bhavata tatra ekameva vastu ashraya visheshcha na syat. There it is not possible. Prakrute and in the context, prakrute cha antakkarana tadvrityoshcha bheda bhavat. Where do you see vrittis? Only in antakkarana. You don't have a separate vritti. You don't have indriya vritti. You don't have sharira vritti, chakshu vritti. We don't talk about such vrittis. Vrittis are always in the antakkarana. So you cannot show the bheda between the vritti and the antakkarana. Really, you cannot show. Thereby, prakruteca antakkarana tad vrityoscha bheda bhava. There is no difference between antakkarana and vritti. Really, there is no bheda. Bhavat na antakkaranam svavritte vishayi bhavati. Therefore, antakkarana cannot be a vishaya. It can be an ashraya for vrittis, but it cannot be the vishaya for vrittis. Kintu ashraya matram bhavati. उपादान कारणत्वाद अंतकरणस्य स्वृत्तिम प्रति सो कार्य कारणात् न भिद्यते दैट इज द न्याय यूज उपादान कारण अंतकरण इज उपादान कारण इट इज द मटेरियल कॉज फॉर द वृत्ति इफ यू सी व्हाट इज द वृत्ति मेड अप ऑफ इट इज मेड अप ऑफ द सेम सूक्ष्म पदार्थ दैट द अंतकरण इज मेड अप ऑफ अंतकरण इटसेल्फ अपीयर्स एज वृत्तिस कार्य देयर बाय उपादान कारणत्वाद अंतकरणस्य स्ववृत्तिम प्रति आश्रय मात्रम भवति इट इज नॉट अ विषय सो गोइंग बैक टू द मूल टिप्पण वॉज आई लॉस्ट द number there, where this number is very difficult to find. Just give me a moment. Okay, so further, yadi antakkaran vritti, it was here, yeah, savritte vishayi bhavati, it was the earlier point. Antakkarana dharmaha na antakkarana vritte vishayaha. So antakkarana is not a vishaya for vrittis. How about the dharmas of antakkarana? Antakkarana nishta, sukha dukkha ityadi are there in antakkarana. How about the vrittis? Vrittis are not able to objectify the antakkarana, but can vrittis objectify the dharmas of antakkarana? Evam antakkarana vrittihi swashraya antakkarana आश्रित राग द्वेष सुख दुखादि धर्मानपि न विषयी कर्तुम शक्नोति. सिमिलरली एज सेड अर्लियर द वे द वृत्तिस कैन नॉट ऑब्जेक्टिफाई अंतकरण, द वृत्तिस कैन नॉट ऑब्जेक्टिफाई अंतकरण धर्माज ऑल्सो. यदि अंतकरण वृत्ति स्वाश्रय भूतम अंतकरण विषयी कुर्यात तर्हि तदाश्रित तद्धर्म भूतान सुख दुखादीनपि विषयी कुर्यात. सिंपल रीजनिंग, इफ द Ashraya is not known, then Ashrita Dharmas cannot be known. This is analyzed by Bhagavan Bhashyakara in the 13th chapter, Trayodasho Adhyaya of Gita also, under the second shloka, where the Kshetra Kshetrajna are analyzed. Kshetrajna is one who knows the Kshetra. Kshetram Janati iti Kshetrajna. So Sharira, who knows it? That Bhagavan says, I am sarva sharireshu bharata, sarva kshetreshu bharata, aham eva kshetrajnyam, kshetrajnyam chapi mam vidhi, sarva kshetreshu bharata, kshetra is sharira. So sarva sharireshu he bharata, o Arjuna, kshetrajnyam chapi mam vidhi, I am that kshetrajnya. So who is the sakshi really? Gitacharya has already said Sakshi is me in each and every, because I know, if you think that you know the Sharira, then you are not different from Ishvara. Not only limited to that, of course, Aikya, Bhagavan Bhashyakara analyzes there as to who is really this Kshetrajna, and then Purvapaksha is long. On the second shloka, the Bhashya is very long, where this particular point also comes up. And this comes in a very interesting section where the Purvapakshi asks, who has this avidya, which was in the Tippana also. Who has this avidya? So there Bhagavan Bhashyakara says, whoever knows avidya, he has avidya. Who has this avidya? He says, then who knows it? There he says, I know the avidya, but I do not know the avidya one. Is that really possible? So Bhagavan Bhashyakara, there's a long discussion, but in conclusion, he says that whenever you objectify something, you cannot objectify that some guna, you cannot objectify dharma without objectifying its ashraya. So if you know avidya, then whoever has avidya, you know him as well. Him or whatever whatever has avidya, you will know that also, because without that, you cannot just know the guni. You cannot know the guna. Guna is known with the guni. Ashraya is known with the ashrayi known. Similarly here, dharmas, if you say dharmas are to be known, you should be able to know the dharmi also. This dharmi is antakkarana, dharma, sukha, dukkha, ityadi, ragadvesha. So if you say ragadvesha, sukha, dukkha can be objectified by the vrittis themselves, if there has to be a possibility, then vrittis have to be able to objectify antakkarana. Antakkarana as an object to vrittis have been denied in the 58th point, 58th avrata. So here, similarly, therefore, evam antakkarana vritti swashre antakkarana ashrita ragadvesha. Antakkarana is there, which is the ashraya for the vritti, swashraya antakkarana, which cannot be objectified by the vritti. Therefore, antakkarana ashrita ragadvesha is also there. Ragadvesha sukha dukkhadi dharmanapi na vishayi kartum shaknoti. It is not possible. Vrittis cannot objectify dharmas also, which are in the antakkarana, because antakkarana is the ashraya for the vrittis also. यदि अंतकरण वृत्ति स्वाश्रय भूत अंतकरण विषयी कुरिया तरही तदाश्रित तद्धर्म भूतान सुख दुखादीन अपि विषयी कुरिया. सो विदाउट द आश्रय आश्रय बीइंग ऑब्जेक्टिफाइबल आश्रयी कैनॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड. धर्म हैज टू बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड, द धर्मी हैज टू बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड. यतः अंतकरण विषयी कुर्वाणा वृत्ति अंतकरण अभिमुखा भवति. यतः अंतकरण विषयी कुर्वाणा वृत्ति ही न न अंतकरणाभिमुखा भवति तस्मात् अंतकरणवत् तद्धर्माश्च न अंतकरण वृत्ते विषयी भवन्ति. सिंस अंतकरण विषयी कुर्वाणा वृत्ति द वृत्ति विच कैनॉट इट कैनॉट बेसिकली अंतकरण विषयी कुर्वाणा वृत्ति द वृत्ति विच वॉन्ट्स टू ऑब्जेक्टिफाई अंतकरण कैनॉट ऑब्जेक्टिफाई अंतकरण. सिमिलरली दिस अंतकरणवत् तद्धर्माश्च न अंतकरण वृत्ते विषयी भवन्ति. अंतकरण धर्माज ऑल्सो कैनॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड बाय दी वृत्तिस. अस्ति च अयम अत्र नियम. सो दैट रूल इज मेंशन्ड हियर. वृत्ति ही स्वाश्रयात् किंचित् विप्रकृष्टमेव वस्तु विषयी कुर्यात् न अतीव विप्रकृष्टम् न अपि अत्यन्तं सन्निकृष्टम् वाइति. व्हाटएवर इज सेज दैट किंचित् विप्रकृष्टम् द नियम. व्हाट कैन वृत्ति ऑब्जेक्टिफाई? वृत्तिस कैन ऑब्जेक्टिफाई स्वाश्रयात् किंचित् विप्रकृष्टमेव वस्तु विषयी कुर्यात् डिफरेंट फ्रॉम इट्स आश्रय विच इज अंतकरण. सो वृत्तिस कैन ऑब्जेक्टिफाई समथिंग अदर देन अंतकरण. किंचित् विप्रकृष्टम् समथिंग डिफरेंट. न अतीव विप्रकृष्टम् समथिंग विच इज टोटली डिफरेंट देन द अंतकरण. कंप्लीटली हैज नो रिलेशन एट ऑल. दैट कैनॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड. एंड अत्यंतम सन्निकृष्टम् वा इति विच इज एक्सट्रीमली क्लोज ऑल्सो कैनॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टिफाइड. यथा Now he gives an example to drive home this point, a little complicated, not much to be discussed here. Yatha nayana vrittihi swashreya samipastha samipastam anjanadikam na vishayi karoti atyantam sannikrishtatva. Why can't vritti objectify something which is very close? He gives an example. Look at nayana. Can the eyes see something which is very close to the eyes? Eyes cannot really see. What he gives an example of swashreya samipastha. the swashreya samipastha, the golaka samipa, chakshu golaka samipa is what? Anjanadikam. If you have put a anjana, the ointment, kajal, what is a kajal? If kajal is put on the eyes, they cannot be seen by the eyes. So, na vishayi karoti atyantam sannikrishtatva. Now, this is not saying that if you put a lot, then you can see. Not that in that manner. Exactly how it has been put, you cannot make out. So, it's some example is given to drive home the point that if it is very close, see, you have to take something. If you want to read something, you cannot keep, however good your eyesight, you cannot keep very close to the eye. It has to be taken at a particular distance for the vritti to form, which can objectify. So vrittis cannot objectify if it is very close. You may be able to see something vaguely, but can you really see it clearly? Pustaka may be seen, but can you make out really whether it is pustaka? You have to say, move it a little further, let me read. You have to move it further. So that is the example given here to drive home the point. Similarly, vrittis cannot objectify something very close. Katha antakkarana vrittirapi swashraya antakkarana gataan sukadukhadin atyanta sannihitan dharman navishai kuryat. So another way it is explained that not only ashraya, they are very close to the vritti, therefore it cannot objectify. Ittham antakkaranam taddharmascha na indriyanam antakkarana vrittescha vishayi bhavanti. Thereby it is established that antakkarana and antakkarana dharmas are not the object of indriyas or antakkarana vritti itself. Kintu kevala sakshina te vishayi kriyante. Thereby we have anubhava. If we have anubhava, who is objectifying it? The sakshi alone can objectify. Vrittis and vishaya cannot become one in the case. See, how does the ghata vishaya jnana take place? When the vritti gatta chaitanya, एंड घटगत चैतन्य विषयगत चैतन्य बिकम वन ड्यू टू दी वृत्ति गोइंग देयर मेकिंग अ वृत्ति व्याप्ति एंड देन टेकिंग अवे तूला ज्ञान ऑफ द घट देन दी चैतन्य बीइंग वन इट गिव्स फल व्याप्ति एंड देन आई से घटमहम जानामि घटमहम पश्यामि दिस इज when this is the case vritti gata chaitanya becoming one with the vishaya gata chaitanya for that vritti has to take place vritti to take place this antakarana and antakarana dharmas being very close they cannot be objectified by the vrittis therefore there cannot be vritti vyapti if vritti vyapti cannot be there cannot be phala vyapti and the antakarana and antakarana gata dharmas cannot be known so there can be no anubhava of sukha dukha but there is anubhava of sukha dukha then how are these known they are not known through vrittis sukha dukhas are pratyaksha not through vrittis how are they known sakshi pratyaksha so we have a sakshi knows it directly without the antakarana kintu kevala sakshinate vishayi kriyante iti hi vedanta siddhanta this is the vedanta siddhanta we look at it more as to now we have landed on these sukha dukha ityadi being sakshi pratyaksha now next point is aneka sakshinam ekena brahmana aikya asambhava this is analyzed now who is the sakshi and the sakshi objectifies the sukha dukha is established Now we'll look at it as to aneka sakshis being there. How can they be one with Brahma or not be one with Brahma in the next paatha? Tomorrow there'll be no paatha being Guruvara. Sukam nityam swaprakasham vyapakam namarupayo adhishthanam buddhyabodhyam buddhirdrukyatva nirmalam aparam sarvedanta vedyam pratyakparam tadevahannamattu anyat iti me nishchitamatihi. Any questions? Any certain sections are going to get a little complex we'll see how much we can see we'll see how much tippana helps but anyway as long as we get the overview in the moola that should be sufficient okay no questions I'll see you in the next paatha on Friday namaste
हरिओम.